Hey guys, so getting closer to taking this car out for a test drive. Right now I'm in the process of putting all new oil in the engine. Since we do have that gasket leak, I want to make sure there's new oil before I drive the car, so it has less of a chance of blowing up and spinning a bearing or anything like that. So I wanted to show you something pretty interesting here. Might help you guys out in the future if you ever do have a gasket leak in the engine. If you ever want to know how bad the actual leak is, well, as you can see here, I have several containers to catch the old oil in. And I've loosened the bolt just a little bit so I can use it by hand here. And I'm going to loosen it and you guys watch and see what pours out of this bolt in the beginning. All right, let me seal this back up here, and you guys can see how bad this looks. Okay. Now, I have a clear container so you can see it better. And if you look here, you can see the milky colored substance. And you can see the green antifreeze actually separated from the oil. There's a bunch of the liquid running around in the pan right there. And the oil itself is just a big pile of goop. I mean, it isn't even oil anymore. It's just a mush. And yeah, you don't want that in your engine circling through everything. That's not going to help things at all. In fact, it could probably plug some things up. So it's a good thing I am changing this oil. That's why you definitely want to change the oil after you get a gasket leak. It'll help clear that out a lot. So I'm going to go ahead and pull the plug out and see how much this stuff is all nasty. It might be all of it. We might not even have any black oil left in this car. It's all mixed together so bad. So let's go ahead and pull the plug off. Keep this container down here and see what we can all catch in it. It looks like it's pretty bad. I'll have to check and see if any of this is also in the radiator, because that can gum up your water pump, cause some more problems. Oh yeah. That's all pretty much just a gray coming down to the container here. And because the radiator is part of this oil, I really don't know how much fluid is in the engine in the oil compartment. So I have an extra container to catch some of this when this one gets full. By the way, that's another cheap trick for you guys. Instead of buying containers to catch oil in, just go to garage sales and buy really cheap containers that people are getting rid of for like a quarter or something. Works great. Alright, I'd say this one's about full, so I'm going to swap containers over. Alright, there we go. And it's starting to turn a little bit more color of an oil, but definitely still thick and goopy and still has that gray tint to it. So it looks like it had a pretty good amount of antifreeze and water that got into the oil. Not good at all for this car. Maybe after I cycle this stuff through and put that new oil in it, it's not going to have as much white smoke coming out of the exhaust from burning it in the cylinders. So, we'll let that finish doing its little thing there. I ain't got too much more to go. And I'd also like to point out something else I'm doing with this car, with the fluids. Because it has the gasket leak, you know, it's going to have the tendency to go ahead and keep putting antifreeze back in the oil. So what I picked up, and this is actually what I run in all of my Derby engines. I don't know about you guys. I'm curious, let me know whatever oil you guys do use, what type of oil. But that there is 20W50, which is some of the thickest car oil that you can buy. So my plan and thinking is the thicker the oil, the longer it's going to take to break down when the heat of a Derby engine starts getting overheated. And also the thicker the oil is, the harder that it's going to be to break through any seals or any leaks. If you have the thinner stuff, it's going to come right through it. So yes, that's why I always try to buy something thick and heavy duty. Now a lot of guys will get the racing stuff and high quality things, but since my engines aren't really racing engines, I don't have a problem with it. And that will be what I'm going to put back into this engine here. Just the normal stuff. So, just thought I'd show you guys what it really looks like coming out of the bottom of the car when all that antifreeze and oil is mixed together. It's pretty nasty, goopy stuff. You do not want to leave your engine running with that cycling through. I'm going to go ahead and plug that thing back up when it's done, put some new oil in this car, and let's see if we can actually take it out for a test drive. See what happens with it. Make sure the transmission still works.